So what is, what happened? Nostalgia is great, but one of the problems is that when even Muslims look at that, well, if only we could capture the golden age back, everything would be fine. But actually, that's not the case. And the reason is that the way we look at nature fundamentally changed after scientific revolution, after the Enlightenment. And one of the key differences was this separation, that the way we look at nature, there is a field, there is a profession, scientist, science. If you were looking at nature, say for example, in the 15th or before 15th, 14th, 13th century, it would be all being to work together. In fact, most of the religious people, clergy, clerical members, imams, or religious scholars, there won't be much distinction because when they are looking at nature, it's not that different than doing works God, God's work. Now here, it makes a difference. After the Enlightenment, it was like, well, no, it's a separate thing. When you look at nature, you can look at nature just for understanding nature. It doesn't have to tie into religion. Now that's a very different type of worldview. In fact, it wasn't just science and religion that got separated, but there were other things also, and there's a philosopher, Mark Lilla, who calls this the great separation. So, but what is the relevance? How do we think about the contemporary science today? Well, this is, unfortunately, it's a little dark, but this is just the number of papers. If we look at the numbers of publication, scientific publications from the Muslim world, they are negligible. So for example, this is just for 1 year of publication. This is from Nature. And most of the graph, these are different Muslim majority countries, and the numbers are around 500 or so. Just as a comparison from the US, the average number of publications per year are a couple of 100,000. Okay. Now, there have been some Nobel laureates, but only two from the Muslim world. In fact, both of them are actually mentioned in the exhibit also. So this is Abdul Salam, who's from Pakistan, who got a Nobel Prize in 1979, and Ahmed Zawail, who's an Egyptian Nobel laureate, who got a Nobel Prize in chemistry in 1999. That's it.